Don't know. Oh, finally it's on. Well, thank you very much. Good afternoon. My name is Eusebio Mujal. I am a professor of government at Georgetown, and I'm very honored to be here with you and certainly to join our fellow panelists. I listened with great interest to the earlier conversation, semi-lecture that you had with Professor Starin, and I was struck by the question that he posed to you, the many questions, but particularly one, and the answers that you gave, which was the very basic question of what is this conference about? And I think that this conference, as the title suggests, is about global challenges and about local answers. But that is only part, I think, of what it is about. It is about understanding, I think, that the global is not only local and that the local is global, but that they are more than intertwined. They are more than connected. They are, in a sense, to use an almost theological terminology, consubstantial, because the solutions to the global and are in the local and vice versa. But the point that I want to make at the beginning is not just that they are so intimately connected, the global and the local, but also to insist on two things. The first, more historical commentary, which is that I think it is not a question simply of identifying solutions and coming up with technocratic answers. It is to understand that the challenge of identifying these problems and their hopeful solutions are in fact marked by an era, an epoch of transition. We are, I think, in the era of the transition to a great uncertainty with respect to the representation and the representativity of institutions. I think that debate, that conversation, was for a long time, from probably the 1940s until the 1990s or even until early this century, was postponed. And it was postponed because the great challengers to our interpretations about representation, those that tried to force a conversation, were fascism on the one hand and communism on the other. And they were both relatively easy adversaries to counter in ideological and in political terms. The problem now is that representation of local, regional, national, and international institutions, their legitimacy is all under challenge. So that not only do they confront deeper questions of an interdependent and intertwined world, but in fact, the institutions themselves need to be renovated in order to be able to address them. And if we looked for historical points of comparison, those points of comparison should inspire us to a certain amount of pessimism, if not realism. Because the nearest points of comparison that we can find are actually in the 1920s and the 1930s, and if we chose to go 40 or 50 years before, to the late 19th and the early part of the 20th century, neither one points in history that ended very well, at least in the short or the medium term. But the second point I want to make, and simply as an introduction for our distinguished guests and, of course, to this distinguished audience, is that the problems seem to ask, for technical solution, for technical proficiency. But of course, no problem lacks politics. All of these problems are deeply political. And what is more, I think, tied to this crisis of representation, the problems require that we approach the solutions from the point of view of empowering citizens. If we do not empower citizens at the local, at the state, at the regional, and at the international level in the variety of ways, whatever solutions we adopt or seek are going to fail. It is only a question of time. And so from that point of view, I would like to simply turn to the panelists and let us have a conversation between all of us.